Hi, this is the session where we'll study about the prehistoric rock paintings. The resource material is derived from NCERT books. This is the basic understanding about the prehistoric rock paintings and to give you the context how and where you will get the more elaborate resources to study about the rock painting. So basically we'll understand the facts that are present in the NCERT books and have a brief context about what exactly are the prehistoric rock paintings, why do we study them, what is the basic purpose of studying the rock paintings. Here you need not to remember the entire facts. The only things that are to be remembered are the important sites where the rock paintings are found. These will help be helpful in the objective type questions. The context behind the rock paintings is that these help us understand the culture, the ideologies, the way of living of the prehistoric periods. So going by the facts, let us recall why the paintings are important. They give us a brief context about the kind of wild animals that were present there, how the humans were associated to each other. These paintings were basically, the reason behind drawing these paintings was to have a beautiful and colorful visual record of that particular day or that particular period. The paintings were rather simple. The pattern of studying these rock paintings is basically in the seven historical period, but we will cover only the two major periods, that is the Upper Paleolithic and the Mesolithic. The other one are the Chalcolithic and the later on stages, but we will not go into that because the major part is covered in these Upper Paleolithic and the Mesolithic periods. The paintings were basically of three types. These were the paintings using the colors, the engravings on the rocks. So engravings means basically scribbling or scrapping of the rock to get an impression on the rock without using any color. If we categorize the kinds of patterns these paintings have, we have three categories: the human characters, the animal characters, and the geometric patterns. So basically these patterns were used for storytelling. Of the seven historical period, if we go about the Upper Paleolithic period, the characteristics of the paintings found in this period are the linear representation in green and dark red, the animal figures predominantly found in these paintings are elephants, rhinos, boars, sticks, like humans. So the human shapes, the human beings were represented in stick shapes, having two hands and legs. They look like sticks. If you talk about the Mesolithic period, so the largest number of paintings was found in these periods, and majorly the hunting scenes were predominant in this. The color used in this period were white, yellow, orange, red, ochre, purple. These colors were basically derived from the rock minerals or the other available rocks. So the major figures predominant in this were the elephant, bison, tiger, leopard, and also it has the human figure of male, female, and children, which were distinct. These paintings were basically drawn upon in the rock shelters where the prehistoric humans lived, and on the ceilings of the caves, reason being because it was more visible there. Now, if we talk about where these rock paintings were basically found, so you need to understand that these paintings were basically found where the human shelters were available, where the human beings lived. So the caves, basically on the walls of caves, which are situated in Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, and Bihar, and some paintings are also reported from the Kumaon Hills in Uttarakhand. Bhimbetka is situated in Madhya Pradesh. We have an extensive list of the sites where rock paintings and engravings are found. So if we talk about the major sites where these rock paintings are found, are Almora in Uttar Pradesh, Agra in Uttar Pradesh. We have Varanasi, Mirzapur. In Madhya Pradesh, we have Gwalior, Pahalgarh, Sagar, Panchmadi, Bhanpur, Kota. Now moving to the facts, this was the context of the rock paintings. So these are the prehistoric important sites which can be remembered for the objective questions, like Mirzapur. The center are Likhuniya, Basauli, Lori, Khobar, Vijaygarh and Ahirora. Now the famous paintings is, of these areas are the poaching scene of Sambhar using a spear scene. Okay, Gadwal in the Kumaon region. The centers are Lakhudiyar in Almora and Dalband in Chamoli. The famous painting is the dancing humorous representation of human figurine, like thin skin. Raigarh in Madhya Pradesh, Singhanpur, Khabra Hills, Kaitpur, Baniyaberi. Human figurines holding as mermaid, dragon and agriculture activities are depicted here. Panchmani area in Madhya Pradesh, Bazar Cave, Mahadeva Cave. The famous paintings are collective poaching by men and women having prehistoric arms. In South India, we talk about there are multiple sites, Kurnool, Beta Marcharla, Mucharla, Chityani, Adoni, Balchakar, Odidaka, Tirupati, Reshapali. And the famous painting here are long-horned and large-bellied animals in running posture, representation of magic and mythology. So the context here is, apart from the sites, important sites of the prehistoric paintings, the context here is, we need to understand how these people of the prehistoric times select the themes of their paintings, what were the reasons of depicting more animals figures than human figures. Basically, the main source of food was animals, so depicting animals in their pictures. And so the reason ascertained here is that they get courage to kill the animals while hunting. So these paintings give us more or less a clear idea about the lifestyle, about but about the life, like animals, humans, as well as the patterns of the activities, social activities which were taken care of. For more detailed information, you can refer to various